What's up, guys? Okay, today we're doing 300ZX rear end. I've done all the front end, as you saw in my previous videos, like the control arms, sway bars. I did the power steering rack and basically did everything in the front. Now it's time to remove the subframe in the rear, the diff, and rear sway bar, rear control arm, and redo all those bushings. So here's all the bushings I'm replacing, and then this is a this is for the diff, and this is the diff bushing right here. This is the aftermarket diff bushing with a like a metal box. This is a pretty common upgrade for 300ZX Z31 for the diff. It'll help it stay more stable in there. But anyways, everything is all Polyurethane or Prothane, same stuff basically. But yeah, subframe bushings, control arm bushings, sway bar stuff, and then diff stuff. Comes with all the hardware, and let me show you under the car. Show you what we're working with. All right, so here's my rear diff. It's obviously pretty leaky, so I'm gonna drain the diff first, and then basically just start disassembling all this stuff all right here. So this is your control arm right here. So I'm changing out that bushing. Bushing over there, sway bar bushing, sway bar bushings. As you can see too, they're super cracked and old. So there's literally no life to them left. And the rear end definitely feels really sloppy. This is what the rear diff bushing looks like right now. As you can tell, it's way different. It's also cracked. So this whole rear end subframe, all of it moves around. It's just, you know, everything's 30 years old, so everything's dry rotted and basically done for. So I'm gonna take all this apart. I'm gonna clean it all up, repaint everything black, make it look really nice again. I might go get all the hardware zinc coated, haven't decided yet. I'm going to repaint the diff, reseal the diff. I might get the diff welded. I'm not sure yet. This is probably gonna be a two-part video. So one's taking apart all the suspension and maybe cleaning it up. The second part might be installing all of it with all the new bushings. Just depends on what I'm gonna do. I'm not doing this all in one day because I just don't have time like that. And when you redo a whole rear end, yes, it is possible to do it one day if you start early in that day and you get, you know, and even if you have somebody helping you, it's even better, but you'll still finish by like late night. Doing a rear end on a car takes a lot of work, and you just have to realize that and just know what you're getting into. I've done this before. It takes a lot of work and it takes a while, but that's also why I have two cars, so I can have this car down and literally just work on it a little bit every single day if I want to for the next week. I have no rush. I don't need to be in any rush, because I have my 370 I'm rolling around in as my daily. I'm gonna take you along with throughout the process and basically show you everything. But yeah, it's just basically, you know, taking everything off in a certain order and then cleaning it all up and redoing it. So I'm gonna start by taking off my wheels, and then first thing you basically have to do is I'm gonna take my diff off first. So I think I'm gonna take this back part of the exhaust off, where it's like from the cat to the back, and then I am going to probably start undoing my diff, and I'm gonna take my diff out first. And then after that, I'm gonna take out my sway bar, I'm gonna take out my rear brake lines, and then I'm going to probably do control arms, and then I'll leave the axle subframe for last. But yeah, I'm gonna get started and I'll show you along the way.
Richer than the richest. Yeah. More money, bitches. Coming to you live from the city of Houston, Atlanta, Vegas.
So what it do, young nigga? 100.
I am on a 24-hour champagne diet. Spilling while I'm sipping, I encourage you to try it. I'm probably just saying that cause I don't have to buy it. The club owner supply it. Boy, I'm on that fly shit. I am with everybody in my past. Don't want me to be, guess what, I made it. I'm the motherfucking man. I just want you to see, come take a look. Get a load of this nigga. Quit frontin' on me, don't come around and try and gas me up. I like running on E, I'm on my Disney shit, goofy flow. On records, I'm Captain Hook, and my new car is Rufio. Damn.
Okay, what you saw me there was just break off all the bolts on the axle going to the hub. There's four bolts on that side, and then that one. The other bolt is just stuck on the actual axle. Reason why I did that first is because I hit this with PB Blaster. These bolts are on pretty tight. So I'm just letting that soak, so they'll be easier to come off. I'm gonna try that in like a couple minutes. And I'm gonna take this exhaust off. Now I got these axle bolts out. I'm gonna take off these four bolts off the diff. I'm gonna bring them over my jack, put it underneath this diff, and then I'm gonna hold it up, and then I'm gonna take off these bolts right here, and then slide this diff right out. And I'll show you that process, and yeah, it's pretty simple. Okay, so those two bolts came out right there. Just a little PB Blaster helped loosen them up. As you can see, they're very rusty. But now they're out. Now it's got a couple bolts on the muffler. I can take this out.
Where my roof just go, I'm somebody that you should know. Get to shaking something, cause that's what drummer produced it for. Yes, I make mistakes that I don't ever make excuses for. Like leaving girls that love me and constantly seducing hoes. I'm losing my thoughts, I said damn, where my roof just go. Top slipped off like Janet at the Super Bowl. I got it, and I can't blame.
Okay, so I got the exhaust out. The trick to getting this exhaust out is... What you gotta do, you can't just pull it straight out because it's just too compact in here to take it out. So basically, you know, it laid right here. What you have to do is go all the way underneath the car, and you're gonna have to take your drive shaft off. You have to take it off anyways to get the diff out. So, but take the four bolts out so it can be loose just like this, and it has room to move around. Because one of those is stuck just right here, the back end of the exhaust right here didn't have enough room to, you know, move around in here to kind of wiggle its way through this hole right there. But once you take this drive shaft bolts out, which is 14 mil and only four of them, just use two 14 mils and then hold one side and then undo the other side. Once you have that undone, you can finally slide the exhaust out straight out like this. You're gonna have to move it. You're gonna have to like modulate it around a lot, but it will come out finally. Also, make sure your axles are off so these things have room to move around as well. I took the heat shield off right here, so they have more room to move around, which helped out a lot too. And the exhaust is held on by a rubber mount right there. A rubber mount right here, and then also there's a bracket that goes on top of the differential right here that holds onto it, and also obviously the two bolts that goes to the catalytic converter. But then you can take out your whole exhaust. So now that I have this exhaust out, as you can see right here, it's out of the way. Now I can start taking everything else out. Also, just to mention too, with your factory exhaust, you can hear all the stuff broken inside there. Like when I move it around, I don't know if you can hear it on camera. I believe that's all cat dust. Like, cause I think my cat's broken. So all that stuff's rolling around in there. And also, as you can see right here, I have holes in this exhaust. So this exhaust is obviously bad because I have exhaust leak right there and have a bunch of shit inside of it. But I'll take care of that when I actually put an exhaust on here. I'm not gonna put this exact same thing back on the car when I'm finished, because I also do wanna get down and run before I do any performance stuff as far as like for the engine. But yeah, now I'm gonna take out the diff. I just had to, you know, take a break real quick after taking off the exhaust, because this did take a little while to do. I just kind of had to figure out how to do it, because I obviously I didn't know what the trick was. Now I do. Now I'm sharing it with you. But anyways, time to take the diff out. Okay, so to get the diff out, you got to get all four of your axle bolts, which are these ones right there on both sides. Got to get these bolts, four bolts right there. Those are like long rods. Hey, look. Just like that. And then obviously the drive shaft bolts I just showed you. So I'm gonna do that real quick, lower this diff out, and then yeah, we'll continue on. Okay, just so you can see what I'm doing right now, I have one jack supporting subframe, because once you take those bolts out, the subframe actually starts to droop. So I put one jack underneath the subframe so it doesn't droop, and then one jack underneath the actual diff. I'm gonna take those bolts out now, and then slowly lower this diff out.
We certified getting it. CM, YM, cash money business. Higher than the ceiling.
Okay, so here's the diff. Do it just like how I showed you, and should come out just fine. But as you can see, it's pretty nasty. It's not as heavy as you think it is. I mean, obviously it's a diff, it's heavy, but it's not as bad as like a 370-350Z diff. But yeah, now I got the diff out. Now I'm gonna work on the subframe.
Fly like a bird, hit the Gucci store, and later get served. We smoked out with no roof on it. Them people passing, so we smash on. Binding out, we keep the cash on deck. Lamborghinis and them Bentleys on the V6.
Alright, guys, so. Alright, so just so you can see how bad these bushings are. They're completely just dry rotted and done for. That's the reason why you just have so much movement in your rear end. I mean, these things are all just dry rotted. You can see that. But now they're all getting replaced, so this thing's gonna feel so much better when it's done. All right, now that I got the sway bar off, I'm gonna take off both of the control arms. Okay, so on this control arm right here, you gotta take off. I mean, you can leave it on your brake caliper, you don't have to. I took mine off, but what you're gonna have to do, if you can take your brake caliper off, make sure you take off this line, and then to actually take your control arm off, you're gonna have to take off this brake line right here. Because if you take your control arm off, when the brake line's still on, you can rip your lines, so which is no bueno. So make sure you take that off. And then take off your shock, and then once I loosen the bolts over here and start lowering this, the spring will pop out, and then I just take out the two bolts over there, two bolts right here, and this control arm will go out, and then you repeat the process on the other side.
Louis Lenz iced up with the black diamonds, Cartier, Ferrari, the new spider, no lie, I'm higher than I ever been. Born rich, born uptown, born to win. Fully loaded, automatic six bin. Candy paint, foreign lights, put my bitch in. Born hustling, too big, nigga to size me up. Kept stunting, more money, burning more. They can't help it, and I can't blame them. Since I got famous, for bitch, I got money to blow. Every 24 hours, money in the power. lower. Come to VIP and get a champagne shower. I don't have to worry because everything ours. And I got a big bouquet of Mary Jane's flowers. That Kush, I promise that's my dude, but we don't smoke that Reggie Bush. And I'm with two women, make you take a second look. We popping like champagne bottles, but we never shook. And we gon' be alright if we put Drake on every hook. They can't help it, and I can't blame them. Since I got famous,
Birdman.
Okay, so now both control arms are out. This bolt was a pain in the ass on both sides. They did this weird thing. I guess it's from the factory. It's like the hole's not in the middle, and it's like not big enough for the actual bolt itself. So it stripped both of my my threads on these bolts, which is weird. I don't know why it does that. Both of them are the same way, so you can see. Kind of weird setup, but anyways, now I'm just gonna take off those three bolts on both sides and then your subframe will come out. So let's get to it. Okay, so everything from underneath is now out. Subframe, control arms, differential, sway bar, everything. So I just left some bolts up in there. I'm gonna take those out. I just put them back up there just so I kind of know where they go. I'm gonna end up cleaning out all this underneath here, so I'm gonna get a brush. With some water, some like dish detergent, and I'm gonna end up cleaning this hole underneath the car right here, everything. And then when I get it all nice and scrubbed and cleaned up, and then I'm probably gonna end up spraying. I don't know. I might either just leave it like that, or I'm gonna spray Rhino liner on it, so it's like a protectant basically for underneath my car. I think basically that's what all like this stuff is anyways. It's just like a way older version of it, but yeah, so I'm gonna do all that, and then as you guys can see, this is what the bushings look like. So that's inner sleeve you're gonna have to keep, but you're gonna have to basically press these bushings out. Obviously they're old bushings. When I was taking them out, you can see a lot of flex happening inside of there. So they're definitely needing of some upgrading. Also, this is my subframe right here. So there goes subframe bushing. As you can see, it's cracked. Same thing with the other side. Like that. Here's all the bolts basically for the passenger side, exception of those four, because those are my differential bolts. One of those goes to each of the control arms. That was the one that went right here that had that weird oval spacer and like that piece right there, which I don't know why they did that. It was kind of weird design. So I'm just gonna end up getting two brand new bolts with some normal washers washers to put on each side, just so it's normal, not this. I don't even understand why they even did that. It doesn't make any sense. These are kind of like top hats that went on top of here. I don't think I'll need these when I put the, I might, I don't know. We'll see how the new subframe bushing sit in there. Here is the old differential mounting point. Basically the bushing / mount. That's what it looks like. It goes just like that. Bam. And then it goes up to the top of the car. This is the newer one, the box one. It's a big upgrade. Obviously it won't, this thing flexes around, and you can see it's all dry rotted, just like everything else. This thing's legit a whole metal box. Also, that's the bushing. And then this is the plate that goes on top, just like that. Oops. Just like that. And then this thing goes just like that. So that's definitely gonna be a big upgrade right there. So that's for the diff. Also, I'm looking into finding somebody to weld my diff right now. I'll clean this up, obviously, paint this black, paint that cover silver. And then, so obviously these are your bushings for your control arms. So, like I said, you just need to keep that inner sleeve, but they will go just like that, basically. So, now what I have to do is clean up everything. Oh yeah, these are the rear springs. Here's like the little boot at the bottom. It's destroyed, and the top doesn't look that good either. I'm gonna try to find new boots for those. Cause obviously I'm not gonna put any spring or anything in there cause I'm gonna do a coilover setup on it. But I just gotta clean up everything now. Send off all the bolts to get zinc coated, or plated, I should say. Coated, plated, I don't know how you say it. I guess either one. But yeah, also I'm gonna clean up my rear calipers and repaint them silver. And yeah, so will be the end of this part of this video. This is the disassembly and everything like that. And then this actually might be a three part. I'll do like the third one, or the second one will be like the cleaning and painting part of it. And then the third one will be the reassembly of all of it. And to tell you what the difference is, how it feels and stuff like that. So yeah, just stay tuned. I'm gonna be doing this stuff all week long. So it's a lot of work just cause it's a lot of like tedious cleaning stuff and prepping for paint for all the arms and stuff like that. And then, yeah, so I will probably upload another one within a couple of days. Just when I have everything done, but you guys will get this video now, obviously. So just stay tuned. This car's come together pretty well. It's a lot of work. If you're gonna do this, I'm telling you right now, it's a lot of work. You just gotta be patient, stay motivated, and yeah, eventually it'll be done and you'll be glad it's done, because then you never have to do it again. But anyways, subscribe, like this video, and yeah, I'll see you on part 2.